I mean, I'm very sensitive to atmosphere. I just tend to get desensitized when people make unreasonable demands of me. For instance, last Christmas decided a bit snow clearing for the Borough Council. It snowed a lot that year in Europe. I didn't have to do the snow clearing. I mean, I wasn't financially embarrassed in any way. It just appealed to me. It appealed to something inside me. And what I anticipated with a good deal of pressure was a brisk in the air in the old morning. And I was right. I had to get my snow boots on and I had to stand in the corner about 5:30 in the morning to wait for the lorry to take me to the allotted area. Bloody freezing. Well, that morning, the lorry came, jumped on the tailboard, dipped, and off we went. We got there, shovels up, fags on, and off we went, deep in December snow. Hours before cockcrow. Well, that morning, while I was at my mid-morning cup of tea, shovel by my side, an old lady approached me and asked me if I'd give her a hand with her mangle. Her brother-in-law, she said, had left it for her, but he left it in the wrong room. He left it in the front room. Well, naturally, she wanted it in the back room. It was a present for her, you see, a mangle. So I had the washing, but he left it in the wrong room. He left it in the front room. Well, that's a silly place to leave it, it couldn't stay there. So I decided to give her a helping hand. She only lived down the road. The only problem is, when I got there, I couldn't move this mangle. It must have weighed about half a ton. How this brother-in-law got up there in the first place, I can't even begin to envisage. So whilst I'm there, shoulders on with this mangle, risking a rupture, this old lady was just standing there, waving me on, not even giving me a little finger to give a helping hand. So after a few minutes, I said, "Now look, why don't you shove this mangle up your ass?" "Anyway," I said, "it's out of date. You want to get yourself a spin dryer?" I had a good mind to give her a work over there and then, but as I was feeling jubilant with the snow clearing and all, I just gave her a quick short arm jab to the stomach and jumped on the bus outside.
"My father is deceased. Come, Gavistar, and share the kingdom with thy dearest friend." Words that make me suffice with delight. "What greater bliss can hap to Gavistar, to live and be the favourite of a king? Sweet prince, I come. These thy amorous lines might have enforced me to have swum from France, and, like Leander, gasp upon the sand, so thou wouldst smile and take me in thine arms. The sight of London to these exiled eyes is as Elysium to a new come soul. Not that I love the city, nor the men, but it harbours him I hold so dear, the king upon whose bosom let me die, and with the world be still in enmity. What need the Arctic people love starlight, to whom the sun shines both day and night? Farewell, base stooping to lordly peers. My knees shall bow to none but to the king. As for the multitude that are but sparse, raked up in embers of their poverty, Tanti, I'll fawn first on the wind that glanceth at my lips and flieth away. How now? What are these?"
"At exactly 6 o'clock tonight, I came home from work. My wife Myra was in the bedroom, getting ready, getting dressed for the party. Rosita, our cook, was in the kitchen with her son, Romero. So I took a bottle of expensive champagne out of the fridge. So I headed upstairs, knocked on her door, she opens it. I hand her a glass of champagne. So we kiss, we drink, then we toast. We kiss, we drink, then we toast again. By 7 o'clock, the bottle was empty. I was sloshed, and my wife was completely toasted. Suddenly, a gentle knock on the door. Door opens. A strange young man looking down at us with a knife in his hand. My wife Myra screamed. I jumped, ran for the gun in my drawer, went back to my wife ready to save her life. Suddenly, the strange young man says, "Yo quito ese tablo en chalanda porque es en quinto minuto." I've never seen Rosita's son before. So I aimed my gun at him. Then he moved. My wife Myra screamed. I jumped. She pulled my arm. and I accidentally shot myself in the earlobe. Then he went running downstairs to Rosita, tell her, El hombre que loco, que bang bang. So, I don't know what happened next. They left.
I'm Lily. I've just started today.
Bennett.
I'm Lily.
Hi, I believe her.
Come on. Let's go.
Are you okay?
Look at me now, will I ever learn? I don't know how, but I suddenly lose control. Thank you.